Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Smackdown. I'm Declan.
My name is Jake.
We are coming to you, this time from Detroit, Michigan. What a state. What a city. Crime capital of America.
What a state the state's in. I'm clapping.
It's a new day. Yes, it is.
It is, in fact, the newest kind of day. As out comes Big E and Xavier Woods.
No Kofi Kingston in sight, oddly.
That's strange, but that's just how it works here for some reason. Oh, nice.
Big E is like 300 with that.
Yeah. I was gonna say he's like 290.
Yeah. And look at that, he's swimming on the floor.
He is, in fact, crazy ball. Indeed.
Crazy to go.
They're having a great time here on the opening match of SmackDown.
Yeah. We're so happy after being not on the show last week.
That's just because we don't have a lot of room.
But it's very true.
We only have 3 matches per show.
Of course, these 2 teams going against each other, they will be trying to get into the inaugural SmackDown Tag Team Championship match at Backlash. And here's the other team, already familiar with SmackDown fame with Adam Cole. It is the Undisputed Era.
It is, in fact, yes.
Come on. Ew. Here we go. Sends teammates as well.
It's just how this works.
Yeah, apparently.
The Undisputed Era is here. And they're ready to shock the system that is SmackDown.
Shock the SmackDown.
He's only wearing 1 knee pad. That makes me uncomfortable.
No, the other one's down there.
That makes me uncomfortable.
Yeah. It has that effect on people.
He needs to put those legs away.
It's too much, Bobby. You can't handle that.
Yep. Now, what do you think? Who do you think has the advantage in this match?
Really, it's anyone's game. The experience of both teams, beyond compare. Won't find any other 2 teams quite like these guys when it comes to experience with each other in tag team matches.
Do you think Big E's strength will be a difference maker here for the New Day, perhaps?
It might be, but you know, these 2 technical powerhouses themselves, you know, they find a great way to get around that. You know, it's not always about the offense, sometimes it's about the defense.
Hey, defense is the best offense, after all.
Okay, not that one.
There we go. As they lock up once again, we have some technical difficulties with our referees. O'Reilly with control on Xavier Woods. Woods with the head scissor. Ooh, strike to the midsection, trying to take all the air out of Kyle O'Reilly as... Ooh, they hook up once again. This time Xavier goes for the arm. Ooh, working on that shoulder.
Stop that. Okay, but you're giving off the thought that Xavier Woods would be able to lock up with Kyle O'Reilly like that.
It's not my fault. His fucking like attributes are too high. So, oh, Kofi Kingston's there.
Ooh.
Oh.
Kofi's there. So is Roddy.
Where are these people coming from? We saw it with Mandy Rose on Raw. Why are these managers randomly showing up? Why are these tag partners randomly just in the middle of matches just jumping from the crowd? I mean, hey, maybe they're just trying to not steal the spotlight from their teammates that are in the match. What a fucking combination there by Kyle O'Reilly. My goodness.
Pulls into the center of the ring. And, ooh, targets the hamstrings.
We really, maybe you should go for that Achilles. We've seen Xavier Woods have a massive real-life Achilles injury at the moment. And as I say that, he goes straight for the ankle lock, which in fact targets the Achilles. As I nearly fucking struggled.
Lost. Right there.
Look, I'm not good at this mini game. Ooh. I'm better at the tapping one. It's like he's got him up for a suplex. As O'Reilly is down and out, seemingly. Into the New Day corner. Tries to fight out of it. Woods gets him back in. Oh, he's fighting out again. Oh my Jesus Christ. The flying lariat to the head.
None of that.
Big E was calling for the tag, but O'Reilly smartly breaking it up, getting in front of Big E, getting between Xavier and his partner. Tremendous tag team strategy there from the tag team specialist, Kyle O'Reilly. He goes for that ankle lock again. Big E saw how. Oh my. What the, I got distracted by that. Big E is punching the referee.
He was just able to fight.
There was a massive distraction. I think it may have cost O'Reilly the match already.
Never know, really.
That was a very pathetic uppercut. Into the corner. Into one of those neutral corners.
Ooh.
Ooh, going for those knees again. O'Reilly just vicious, going after body parts. I mean, hey, if Xavier can't stand, he can't do most of his offense.
That is very true.
Now, look at that strength, though. That's
sweet.
Oh my good God, that's one of the things you see from Xavier Woods. Deceptively strong is him. Maybe one of the more agile members of the New Day, but
goes for the leg, gets cut off at the pass.
What the hell is going on here? These two are having almost a tremendous singles match at this point.
Yeah, just completely disregarding their
tag team partners, it seems, as O'Reilly going again for that combination. He sweeps the leg once again. So he's going to try to pull himself up.
Oh, the surfboard.
Not quite. Instead, just more damage to those knees. As he's, you see that? He just kicked him across the ring. Scuffed him around. Looks like maybe a brainbuster. Yes, that's exactly. Floats over.
One.
Oh, Big E having to break it up.
Yeah, that was awfully close.
Ooh, striking that knee. And finally, Woods maybe getting control of this. And now Big E gets into the match. Double flapjack there. Ruddy on the apron, distracting Woods. He's going off at him. It's left too much time and a belly to belly. But Xavier Woods is now out of the ring and very quickly O'Reilly able to kick out Big E's move. Already Big E.
He goes for that combo this time on Big E. Can he trip the bigger man? He does.
It doesn't matter how big you are. You take out those legs. Everyone's almost the same height when they're on their back.
Ooh,
unless they're Big E and they've got massive chests.
Look at that jiu-jitsu stylings.
Just completely wailing and strikes into Big E's face. Woods you just saw on the outside, but unluckily is still on the side of the Undisputed Era. O'Reilly up to the top. Ooh, knee and then a forearm, it looked like.
Yeah.
Now, Big E whipped into that corner. Xavier's finally to his feet.
What could they be going for? Up it goes.
This says cutthroat. Ooh, brainbuster after the kick. Now a pin. One. No, just a one count. Very slow one count kick out, though. Referee stopped counting. And now a huge knee drop. Biggie's head. So he uses his strength and gets him away. What the hell is his signature move? Doesn't matter.
Big splash.
It is the big splash that you counted because you knew I was going for it.
Yes.
You little bastard. Oh my God. Piggy down and out once again. Bobby Fish. Ooh. Jumping a spin kick. I think he missed so he didn't get all of it, definitely. Throwing Woods. Oh, telling Woods to maybe get into the ring? As he does.
Fucking. Ooh.
Woods not having any of that. Picks him up. No. Counter. Ooh, ooh. Roll up. No, into the.
Into is that the fish hook?
This one could be over. Oh my. Big E, what are you doing?
Well, he stopped it.
He stopped it, yeah.
No ref, no count.
The referee's down. Ooh, Big E down. Nearly takes out Kofi Kingston as well. Three slow feet. There's the high kick. Got more of that on Xavier. Maybe that's just the height difference. The referee's back to his feet. This could spell. This could be the end for the New Day.
I think it's this way around.
I have no idea.
No, it's the other one.
Yeah, oh, well. It is the other one. It doesn't matter.
Oh, and there you go. You see it. Total elimination. One, two,
Big E in the ring is in time.
Three.
No. He took out the ref once again. Big E trying everything. Big he doesn't believe this match is over.
Trying to stop it, but, you know, there's no way to stop progress.
Yeah, he hesitated for a split second.
And look who's Adam Cole now.
Hey, Bobby Fish is the one that picked up that victory. Probably would have had Xavier Woods tapping out. That fish hood absolutely dangerous, but Big E taking out the referee. The New Day almost doing everything they could, but it was still just not enough.
Absolutely, but even though that was a scorcher of a tag team match, way better than 3.5 stars, you fuckheads. But I guess we gotta go on with our main event. No, our second match of the night. I'm going to go with our women's match of today.
Now the women relegated to the co-main event, huh? Yeah, don't fucking start on me.
Yeah, no big main event. You didn't even have a main event.
That's not my fault. I booked the main event. It's not my fault. Finn Balor does what he wants.
But anyway, about this match, this is a match to decide the other woman in the SmackDown Live, SmackDown Women's Championship match at Backlash. Of course, Bayley getting a pin in that big opening six-woman tag match. She automatically gets herself into the championship opportunity. Now it's these two, her tag team partners, for that match. Charlotte and Nia Jax will have to face off for the right to be the second person.
And we saw these two work pretty well together as a tag team, taking out the team of the Kabuki Warriors and Io Shirai.
Yeah.
But that teamwork and friendship is now out the window as these two fight for basically exactly what they're here for.
Yeah.
They're fighting for that SmackDown Women's Championship. They're not quite there, but, I mean, a victory tonight puts them in that match, and you'd say maybe with an advantage, considering they might have a little more ring experience than Bayley on this current season of Universe Mode.
You really like talking in long sentences, don't you?
Yes, I'm Michael Cole.
You need to edit. Here she is, her opponent. It's a big task for Charlotte tonight. Probably. As you saw in that tag match, Nia Jax an absolute unit.
Yeah, she's the biggest woman here on the, all of the women's
all
rosters.
Of the women
she's
on the roster. Yeah.
That's why they call her the Irresistible Force. She's almost unstoppable, almost immovable. She's like the equivalent of the Andre the Giant in this women's division.
Yes, absolutely.
Just a bit more athletic.
That's true. But, you know, the 10th wonder of the world has her own things to do.
Mm-hmm.
Get it?
Because she's not the 9th. Yeah. I got it. No, I got it.
Yeah.
I did get it. The 9th one died.
Yes, she did.
And Nia took her place. Wait, if it doesn't exist anymore, does it count?
Does it? No, I think they all... Most of the wonders of the world are gone.
Are they? Well, that's the ancient world. The modern world, they're all still there. That's why they created... Ooh. Oh my god, Charlotte! Very luckily to get out of the way there. I lost my train of thought. Yeah, no, but that's why they created new ones, isn't it? Because they didn't exist anymore.
Charlotte going after the 10th wonder of the world.
Okay, we're just going to stick with it. That works.
Because Andre was already dead when China started calling herself the 9th wonder of the world.
Oh, yeah, that does make sense, actually. You know what? Yeah, no, I take back everything I just said. You're right. That's usually how this goes.
Ooh, finally got Nia Jax down onto the floor.
Yeah, very shockingly. Got it down pretty quickly, actually. Thought Nia might have stayed up a little bit longer, but that shows the power of Charlotte. Ooh, tribute to her dad there, that huge knee. Could be over one. Nope. Once again, those slow kickouts. These referees really aren't good at their job. That should have been a two count, but only the one. Kick to the gut. Maybe looking for a powerbomb?
Up she goes.
Ooh!
Powerbomb this early into the match.
Just going straight for those power moves. Just able to slip through. I think there's that long body of Charlotte. Oh, these two just running into each other. Nia still on her feet. Nia just taking in all these shots. Almost refusing to go down, but are those knees? Yeah, the knees take her out once again. Doesn't matter how big you are, you take out the ribs, the lungs. You take away that breath support, you're going to wind an opponent. They're not going to stay on their feet for much longer. And neither is Charlotte with that huge clothesline by Nia Jax. These pinfalls are really slow. These two fighting it out. Know each other pretty well, countering almost every move. But, oh, Nia not able to counter that one. Probably looking to go up, but Charlotte goes down with the spear. Now, almost uncharacteristically, very quickly going to the top rope. This is uncharacteristic. Calls Nia to her feet. You don't see this very often. Charlotte, cross body into the pin. Could this be all? One, two. Ooh, no. Nia just able to kick out in time. Ooh, rolling neck breaker there. Yeah, she didn't quite get the full extension going over and twisted her neck. Could be some serious issues there.
Okay, well, there we go.
Nia rolling. Looks like she's in pain.
Why?
You picked the wrong move as Charlotte goes for an elbow drop. And then sets up again.
Another elbow drop.
Ooh, okay,
a knee drop. Okay, so it is her signature.
That would make sense.
Yep.
Charlotte. Knee. Fuck, I hit that way too early. Look back, the rude awakening there.
Ooh.
Maybe going for that figure eight, but Nia out of it. Ooh, massive backbreaker.
Damn.
Nia's taking control of this match again. That's just the power of Nia Jax, really. She's got her up. Whoa. Military press. Ooh. Ooh, Charlotte kicked the referee. But Nia just caught her. That's the deceptive quickness of Nia Jax. She's telling Charlotte to come back into the ring. She's backing off. She's going to let her in. That's strange sportsmanship and might have cost her. No, it didn't. Looked like she was going for that neck break again, but Nia had it scouted into a chin lock.
There's no way you can beat
Charlotte's
technical prowess.
Yeah, Nia not exactly known as the most technically gifted wrestler. Ooh, she uses her.
Charlotte was going for the big boot, but...
It looked like it. Ooh, huge senton. Nia kick to the back. Yeah, more technical wrestling them from Charlotte. Looked like she got the big boot into Nia's throat, maybe. She didn't get it all the way to her head. Charlotte it looks like she's caught in the ropes a bit. Is that gonna matter? No, she uses it maybe even for leverage. She kicks Nia in the gut. Natural selection. This one could be over already. Charlotte not going for the pin. And she's sending a message here. Her opponent, I'm assuming now, Bayley's gonna have something to look forward to. Charlotte Bridges, figure eight, Nia gonna tap out.
Tap out, absolutely. Wow.
That's a message to Bayley right there.
Charlotte making the irresistible force. Well, no one won that one.
John Cena is the winner of this match because you cannot see his name.
Woo! Bigger than the
ramp. What's going on here? What a battle.
Respect to both competitors.
Yeah, I agree. Nia. That's the friendship between these two.
This is love. This I absolutely love.
Yes. Oh. That's the friendship. Oh, Corey's talking. I don't know why. We're getting translations from our Spanish announce team, I think.
Yeah. I don't know why. It's
Nia. Nia showing her respect to Charlotte. For that match, maybe even just saying, "Hey, if you win that match in Backlash, I'm coming after you anyway."
That's very true. Yeah.
There's no time for friends here in the women's division.
I think, no matter the winner, I think Nia Jax would probably be high on the list of contenders for the...
I mean, she may have missed out on an opportunity here, but she's definitely one of the top competitors here in the SmackDown women's division.
Absolutely. But enough about that one. We got a main event to deal with.
Close system.
We'll see more Undisputed coming out. Which members are going to be?
Adam Cole, and Adam Cole alone. Here he goes.
Hadn't seen. You hear the crowd going on with him. Adam Cole, Bay is out here, the fourth member of the Undisputed Era, the man we didn't see in that tag team match.
But looks like no one's with him. Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish too tired from their big match. But Roddy, what are you doing?
And who knows? Roddy could jump out of the crowd like he did before.
They're seeing
a very strange thing from managers recently where they just do what they want.
Yeah.
Adam Cole, the final man eliminated in the second to last.
Second to last, yes.
I was incorrect there. Second to last man eliminated from the WWE Championship six-pack challenge.
Yes.
Oh, I want to talk over him, but I really don't want to ruin this. There he goes.
There we go. Now boom.
Yeah. He did his boom.
Would you like me to explain what's happening here tonight?
I was going
to
say, it looks like he may be looking for another opportunity.
Yes, about that other opportunity. This match will be a small tournament of sorts. In the six-pack challenge, Andrade was last eliminated. And that made him the first challenger for Daniel Bryan and his WWE Championship. But the other four men, they will face against each other in order to determine who will be the third man in that WWE Championship match.
I mean, that seems only fair. I mean, Andrade can't just be handed a one-on-one match. He did lose, after all.
Yeah.
He may have lasted long, but yes, he did still lose.
He did,
I think that may be the fairest way of giving these five other men an opportunity at Daniel Bryan's newly won WWE Championship.
And both of these men looking for their first taste of gold here in the WWE.
Yes. The first ever... I mean, everyone's still looking for their first bit of gold. The only person we've seen on SmackDown with any gold around his waist... Well, actually, we haven't even seen him wear it. Well, that's Daniel Bryan.
It's Daniel Bryan. Could he even be wearing the gold?
Who knows? He could do what he wants. He's the WWE champion.
He's the WWE champion. No one's gonna stop him. He's our boss now.
Yeah, he's in charge.
He won that right.
Thank you, Daniel Bryan, for giving these five men an opportunity at your
title. I only had to fight four men for my position. He had to fight five.
I just raised my hand once. And they went, yeah, all right.
Because no one wanted that job. It's Raw.
Yeah, you're right. But hey, I get a job
Dancy
out of it.
Man.
Boom! That's why I get paid the bucks.
That is true.
Not the big bucks.
No, wait, who? The old bucks.
No, not the big bucks. Just the bucks. I get paid decent. But not as well as you, because you have the show everyone likes. You have the job everyone wants.
That's very true.
But now your pay's getting decreased a little bit, because Daniel Bryan's taking most of your job.
Yeah, that is very true.
So he's in charge. He does what he wants.
Got so many responsibilities.
And Nakamura locking up Adam Cole.
Nakamura, of course, the excellently gifted technician and striker. Can Adam Cole... Oh! He's trying.
And that was almost low. And brings him down. Looks like a armlock STO, I'm assuming that's what you'd call that. Well, I mean, that's not a flatliner.
Yeah, a flatliner of sorts.
Adam Cole... Shockingly using maybe more speed than I assumed he would have here of Nakamura. He's holding up that, I'm not sure what that was. He was holding up some kind of sign. I've never seen it before in my life.
No, that's
not a thing. And then looking like a drop kick to the ropes, but that might have just been playing possum
stiff
to Nakamura.
Punch.
Stiff punch. Gets him a one count.
So he's just going to keep the shirt on. I didn't realize that.
He wears his shirt. That's what he wears. Have you not seen Nakamura in the past, 6 months?
I try not to.
Yeah, no, he wears the shirt. And he wears... Yeah, instead of wearing the thing around his arm, he just has it randomly on the shirt. Catching the leg of Nakamura. Huge elbow drop. Ooh, right to the heart, I think that was.
Oh.
Gets him up, but...
Nakamura not standing for that.
Actually, he is standing.
Well, he is now.
Fireman's carry.
Ooh, landslide! Damn, that huge Samoan driver.
But Adam Cole not going to go down that easily. Huge elbow. Fireman's carry of his own.
Ushigaroshi! Goes to the pin. One.
Just a one nothing. Count again. This could be a back and forth matchup here.
To the cross armbar.
Ooh, that's a Nakamura move. Not sure what Adam Cole's going for.
Of course, Nakamura knows too well how to get out of that. Ooh!
It's a move he's making famous in Japan. Adam Cole looking like his own kind of strong style. Strikes. Ooh, yep. Nakamura not having any of it. Look at those forearms and the double palm strike. And now, looks like a... Ooh!
Stun gun.
Stun gun there. I saw Steve Austin win matches with that, but not
this
Nakamura.
Is the current era where we do bigger moves.
It's the Undisputed Era. That's what Adam Cole would say. Back into the fireman's carry. Are we going for it again?
Ooh.
This time, hooks the leg for a pin. But...
Nothing. Oh, wow. Absolute resiliency. How do you do it?
What?
The possum.
Same. If you want to do the pin, it's circle. It's ooh. R2 in circle, but if you want to do an attack, it's triangle. Yeah, I know.
Weird.
It is weird, but you get used to it. Kick to the gut, holding him up. Ooh! Brainbuster on the knee. Referee getting a good position. One. Just a one count. More resiliency shown now by Nakamura. And Cole still on the attack. Are you looking for his big move?
Oh, no. Countered by Shinsuke.
I think he hesitated. Took too long. Gave Nakamura too... Yeah, you'll never counter that. It's ridiculous. I think he may have given him just a little bit too much time. Nakamura, he's screaming. Telling Cole to get to his feet. Cole
didn't
listen.
No, you've got the finisher. That's not the finisher.
I know. Oh, went for the drop kick. Nearly hit his own head on the bottom turnbuckle.
Damn.
Cole too close. And I think Cole was definitely paying possum that time. Now hooks the knees.
Ooh, maybe going after the knees, the King of Strong Style's biggest offense.
Yeah, he's going to hit that Kinshasa if his knees are jelly.
Absolutely.
Off the ropes. Caught.
Ooh! Double stomp right to the gut.
It looks like he's setting up for it. I can't believe he's going to go for it already. Oh, and I think calling for it was a bad idea. Cole was able to catch Nakamura. Super kick.
Ooh.
Trent, yeah.
Into the Florida Keys.
German suplex.
Ooh.
I think maybe too much elevation. Nakamura's height may have helped him. I think he fell out of that more than kicking out. Maybe just that suit, that shirt. I think Adam Cole may not have had...
Ooh. What's he going for? Can't be.
I'm not going to finish my sentence because I think Adam Cole might have this one over anyway. The Panama Sunrise. That Canadian Destroyer 2.
What?
Oh, I don't think he can believe it. I don't think he's happy.
No. Well, would you be? One of your biggest moves than having it kicked out of?
Well, we were talking about it before. That's the resiliency of Nakamura already. Coming into play, up to his feet. Ooh, Ushigaroshi of his own. Now, gonna get him back to his feet.
Ooh,
huge knee strike.
Modified Kinshasa there.
Ooh, and that huge chest kick. There he goes for it again. Ooh, no, this time. Looks like a shining wizard, but with the foot.
Come
some
on,
kind
you
of
dickhead.
Shin
fill
kick.
Up your meter.
Fill up your meter.
I'm waiting for the little... For the
no, I know what you're doing.
Yeah.
It's just not great. What the
I
hell?
Don't think it's filling up at all.
No, it's not.
Great. I wanted to do something special.
Oh, no, I... Yeah.
I wish I was special.
Do you? Does Nakamura...
Oh, queen.
Yeah, we're going to get in trouble if you sing that.
I'm not a steer-do. Crit Nakor. See, that was no song. It wasn't a song. You can't copyright
play
a song.
You know, if you just sing it badly with the wrong words. Explode a suplex.
And this is what he calls for right before. He's going for the Kinshasa. He doesn't have the running one normally.
Oh, I know. I think he does. The hell is going on? Nope, he doesn't, but whatever he was going for, it got caught. Nakamura in the corner. Probably dangerous. Adam Cole not going for that Panama Sunrise again.
Right.
Instead going to the top rope, which is a big shocker. Ooh, elbow drop.
See that. Pin.
Two. Ooh, Nakamura just able to kick out.
Pin, Riff.
Riff. Why don't you count the pin? Cole, maybe not. Oh, got caught. Oh, he got caught again, Nakamura. Maybe smartly there, rolling out. What the hell?
Oh!
Huge insecure. Yeah, sending Nakamura crashing to the outside. Oh, a huge floating body splash. Just putting all his weight on Nakamura.
We saw that coming.
Not me, that's for sure.
Quite a lot of physics there.
It looked like a three count, but it doesn't matter because Adam Cole's got Nakamura back in the ring.
Oh, super kick to the knee. Down the knee. And,
Last
shot, right to the back of the head. It's over. One, two, three.
Yeah, it's over. Ja-ah is the winner of this matchup.
Good for him. Ja-ah wins.
That's just the Spanish spelling of Adam Cole.
Ja-ah wins.
Thank you.
Very good.
A heartfelt victory.
Yeah, big win for that young man. And
Oh,
he's not done.
Wait a minute.
What's he thinking now?
This is classic.
What's it done?
I think he's not finished. He wants to stomp a hole in him.
Classic Adam Cole. He's never finished when a man is dumb.
Adam Cole maybe sending his own message to Daniel Bryan and Andrade.
Hmm. But I guess, what a sour note to end on. Unsportsmanlike conduct by Adam Cole, but we got to finish.
Can't really expect much of him. That's what he does.
But, that's the end of SmackDown, I guess. I've been Declan.
My name is Jake.
And always, stay jamming.
Watch Raw.